Buying an SSD is a great way to speed up a computer that is using a traditional mechanical hard drive. Luckily, you don't have to start over from scratch when you buy one. It's easy and simple to copy all of your data to your new SSD. There's a bunch of software that can be used to clone a drive out there, but one of the most straightforward pieces of software that I've come across is EasyUS to do backup. Despite the fact that this has the word backup in the title, the software is great for cloning drives and being able to optimize the clone for SSDs. To get started, you'll want to download EasyUS to do backup and install it onto your computer. I'll leave a link in the description where you can go and get it. And this is also the point where you'll want to make sure that you have your SSD connected to your computer. If you're using a laptop, you'll need to get yourself a USB to SATA adapter cable so you can clone the hard drive to the SSD before you swap them. If you have a desktop, you should be able to plug the SSD straight into your motherboard and power supply for power, but you may need an additional SATA cable. Once you've connected your SSD, you may want to restart your computer just to make sure that the computer fully detects the new drive. Once you've downloaded and installed EasyUS to do backup, you want to click on the clone button, which can be found on the left-hand side menu bar. When you click on that, a new window will pop up allowing you to select your source drive. This is the current drive that you've been using and it contains your C partition. Click the checkbox next to the correct drive to select the source drive, and now we can move on to selecting the target drive. The target drive is your new drive, which in our case is the SSD. And since the SSD is new, it should have no or one partition on it, which will be empty. This will make it easy to find. You can also use the gigabyte total to find the right drive. In our case, the destination drive is 128 gigabytes. Like before, click the checkbox next to the correct drive to select the target drive. Before you click next, now is the time where you'll want to make sure the cloned SSD is optimized for being an SSD. In the bottom left corner, click the button that says Advanced Settings, and here you can check the Optimize for SSD checkbox. If you've been looking closely, you'll notice that I am cloning a 250GB hard drive to a 128GB SSD. The cloning process automatically resizes partitions for smaller drives. If you're cloning from a smaller drive to a larger one, you'll need to make sure that you make full use of that new available space. So you'll see an edit button next to the right-hand side of your target drive. If you click on that, now you can drag out the main partition so it fills up the new available space. Now before we continue, I'm going to give a quick disclaimer saying that anything on the target drive will be erased. I would highly recommend that you have a backup of your files as a precaution, and I'm not responsible if you lose any data. So if you're happy with that, you can click next, and now you can double check the source and the target drive. And when you're happy with that, you can click proceed, and this will then begin cloning the drives. When the clone is done, you can click finish. You can swap out your old hard drive for your new fast SSD. So that's been it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.